Can you see the screen?
Yes, 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 yes.
Even the book?
Yes.
Okay.
Namaste Guruji.
ॐ वक्रतुण्ड महाकाय सूर्यकोटिसमप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वतीमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा वागर्थायो सम्पृक्तौ वागर्थप्रतिपत्तये जगतः पितरौ वन्दे पार्वती परमेश्वरौ धातुब्रह्मैव सम्प्रोक्तो जीव आख्यातमुच्यते प्रकृतिकृत्सुबन्तादिर्धातुब्रह्मात्मने नमः. So we are looking at the panchavrittis. Panchavritti means the vritti is a statement of derivation in Sanskrit, and each of these derivations has a name, and they are five in number. What it means is finally you will have derived a noun base or a verb base. So verb base is a dhatu, but then dhatus, there are dhatu pata dhatus, which are not avyutpanna. Those are present as they are reverse engineered by Panini Maharshi. So dhatu pata has some 2000 odd dhatus, 2000 or 2200 something. So those many dhatus are there. But you can also derive dhatus from other pratipadikas, and that will be a derived dhatu which is called as sanadhyanta. So sanadhyanta dhatu, and these pratipadikas themselves can be derived from either from a dhatu, where you will get dhatu and a krit pratyaya, and that krit will be at the end, at the anta. Therefore, it will be called as a kridanta pratipadika, and then kridanta pada when you decline that. So we are not talking about the declined ones. The declension is assumed that you will finally, before usage, you will decline the word. So it's not a subanta or a thinganta pada that we are talking about. We are talking about the base which is derived, and that base can be either a dhatu or it can be a pratipadika. The pratipadika can be a kridanta pratipadika when you add a krit pratyaya and to krit pratyaya to a dhatu. When you derive a pratipadika with two or more pratipadikas, then you get either a samasa or a taddita or an ekashesha. There the samasa is a compound where the pratipadikas are retained. The pratipadikas that form a compound are retained. If you get that, and that's a sambandha between two nouns. Basically it's from two declined nouns, and then the declension is removed to compound them. So let's say dasharatasya putraha, that dasharatasya sya is dropped and you get dasharata putraha in a compound. So that's why I'm saying pratipadika plus pratipadikana samasa, but that sambandha is usually in the noun. It is not with pratipadikas, because pratipadika cannot be used as it is. Then once you form the samasa, that will also be a pratipadika, which is a noun base, and with adding a supratya, it has to be declined before being used. So only a pada can be used, and pada is that which is subanta or tinganta, that which has a supratya in the end or a ting pratya in the end. That is a basic definition of a pada, and only padas are legal to be used in the language. The vyakaranas will not even, the grammarians will not even pronounce a word, they will not even write a word which is not fully declined in a sentence. So during derivation it's okay, but otherwise it's not used, it's not considered sadhu prayoga. Then the same sambandha, if it is expressed by taddita pratyaya, a pratyaya, and the second pratipadika is not retained, but the meaning of the second pratipadika is carried. Meaning of the sambandha of the first and the second pratipadika is retained. That is a taddita vritti, and the pratipadika is called a taddita pratipadika. Then, if you in a samasa, the if one word retains the meaning of both, or can be in some cases more than two, but more than one. But if the let's take two, what we saw is Mata Pitaru. Mata Pitaru, the meaning of Mata and Pitaru is Mata and Pita, both are retained in the word Pitaru. Only one remains and it carries the meaning of the other also, that is called as Ekashesha. Now let's look at these in little more detail. We'll not look at Ekashesha more, we'll not look at Sanadi, we'll look at few examples of Sanadi, but Krut we'll look into and we'll look at the, so let's say Sanadi. So Sanadi Pratyah, Sanadi is because San Pratyah and there are others also, Yang, Nich. So all these Pratyahs, these can be used to give a particular sense to the word which is derived and with the verbal base. So that verbal base in a particular meaning will become a Sananta Dhatu. So for example, here Nya Dhatu is Nya in the sense of to know. And sun is used to in the sense of the desire to do something. So sun, the basic meaning is a desire to do. So desire to know, if you in that sense you can add the sun pratyaya to jnya. So jnya dhatu is to know and sun dhatu to desire to do some kriya. That what, which is that kriya? Jnya, which is indicated by the kriya indicated by the dhatu jnya. So jnya, so desire to know, desire to do something which is indicated by the verbal base, which is to know. So desire to know will be jnya plus san. And when you make jnya plus san, there is some lot of things take place, like duplication of the dhatu, etc. So you see jnya and jnya will become jnya jnya. And then some other kriyas happen in the earlier pada, but you will get jidnyasa. Jidnyasa is the new dhatu now. This new dhatu, which is a sanadyanta dhatu, because san or sun, etc. The section starting from sun, whether it can be sun or young or niche, there are some pratyas, and these pratyas are called sanadi, sun, etc. And sanadi anta, sanadi is in the end, at the end for which, sanadi ante yasya, to that dhatu which has sun, etc. pratyas in the end. So that is jidnyasa. So jidnyasa is a new dhatu derived from jnya, which carries the meaning of to desire to know. So jnyatum iccha jidnyasa. That is how the laukika vigraha will be. Laukika vigraha is the worldly vigraha. The alaukika vigraha is a technical vigraha, which will be jnya plus san. So jnya plus san has the meaning of jnyatum iccha. So jnya plus san equal to jidnyasa, and jnyatum iccha equal to not jidnyasa, but the dhatu cannot be used. In a sentence, you have to decline the word. So, it will be declined by adding a strilinga pratyaya to this jidnyasa and making it a noun. First, it will be made a noun and then in strilinga. You see this word in strilinga, the sananta dhatus decline in strilinga as a noun. And jnyatum iccha will be jidnyasa akaranta, while the alaukika vigraha will say jnya plus sanikul jidnyasa. Jidnyasa is a dhatu, but it cannot be used. That's why jidnyasa in a sentence. Laukika vigraha is a sentence. Jnyatum iccha jidnyasa. Similarly, moktum iccha munch dhatu. So moktum iccha will be mumuksha. That's how we get the word mumukshuhu. Then mumuksha will be the new dhatu. And then when it is declined with a kartari vyutpatti, that a karta of one who has mumuksh, so an agent of desiring to be free, will be called as mumukshuhu in masculine, and the dhatu will be mumuksha, and in strilinga the bhavya vyutpatti will be mumuksha. Moktum iccha mumuksha, a desire to be free is called as mumuksha. That's also another sanadyanta vyutpatti. Kru dhatu, you add san, you will get chikirsha as a new dhatu. It will become kru, and something else happens in chi, that kru will become cha, the kakara will become chakara, and ru actually becomes a, and then it is replaced by e. Some prakriya happens there, but you will get chikirsha. This chi is also a modification of kru only, and kir, if you see kir, kru has become kir, that is also a modification there, but you can see the kakara and chakara are very close. Jidnyasa, jnya is a jakara and nyakara. It's a conjunct consonant, but the initial letter in jnya is a jakara. That jakara you see here. So you see some kind of duplication happening, and thereby you know if the dhatu is duplicated, then it, either it is in the third gana, which you would see third gana dhatu gets declined when it is gets duplicated when it is declined in as a tinganta. So either it is a third gana dhatu or you know that it can be sananta. If sa is there in the end, sa or the sakara can also take murdhanya. Murdhanya as in it can become cerebral. The dantya, the dental can become cerebral and you may see this sakara change to shakara. So if you can see sakara or shakara in the end, like jidnyasa, you see sakara and then a or shakara and a. So you can guess that reduplication and a sakara or shakara it gives away that it is a sananta dhatu. Nya plus nich. So nich is in the sense of causative. There is another swarthi nich also in the 10th gana. That will also be nich, like chori. Chur dhatu will become chori. That's a dhatu. Where, that's a 10th gana dhatu. Although dhatu pata lifts the chur, but when you take that dhatu out to decline, so it will become chori. And then when you add shap and when you decline with the tip, in the it will decline like a first gana dhatu and you will get chorayati. But chorayati can also mean causative, or in any other gana, when you add nich, that will be causative. That will be causative as in to make someone to do something. So if you make someone to know, or which meaning the dhatu will be, and it takes something called as a pug agama, an augment, and then the content of that is pakara. So you get nya plus nich will be nyapi. The dhatu will be nyapi. Ikara here, the pakaras, the ikara after pakara is this content of nich. Nakara drops off, chakara drops off, the content is e, and nya plus pakara is an augment which will come and sit in between this, and you will get a nya plus pakara plus e of nich, so you will get nyapi. And the, when you decline it, you will get nyapayati, make someone know. So teaching also, reveal something or make someone know, that is nyapi. The dhatu will be nyapi. Kru plus nich. Now kru plus nich will be kari. It will take a vruddhi. This nich causes something called, we have seen vruddhi. The vruddhi for ru is a, and we have seen whenever a is a replacement for, whenever an is an adesha for any guna letter, then it takes when ru is replaced by an an, then it will be followed by a repha. So a plus repha will get r, so you will get kar, and kar, the content of nich is e, you will get kari as a new dhatu. So karayati, make someone do. Karoti, otherwise it will declare as karoti, kru dhatu will get karoti, someone does, but someone makes someone else do, causative, in that sense it will be karayati. Karoti, he himself, saha karoti, saha karayati api, he does as well as make someone else do. That is a sanadi, in the sense of sanadi. Krit vritti. Let's look at krudanta. Krudanta is a dhatu plus a krit pratyaya will give you a new pratipadika called krudanta pratipadika, and then you decline it and you will get a noun. So nya plus say one krudanta pratyaya in kartari sense, and these the krit pratyayas, the benefit of krit pratyaya is it will decline like a noun, and nouns are easier to decline. The declination wise, nouns are easier to decline compared to the tinganta, because tinganta is quite wide. 10 dhatus and then kartari prayoga, karmani prayoga, all 10 dhatus have a different vikarna pratyaya which modify the, so there are lot of varieties which are available in the dhatus, and therefore tinganta is quite vast. And then 10 lakaras also, 10 lakaras and then 10 ganas, 10 lakaras, kartari prayoga, karmani prayoga, bhave prayoga, vikarna pratyas, all these will cause a vast set of declensions which are not easy to remember. So these are easier to learn by sutras. You will get some sets can be known through few sutras, but subantas, you need more sutras to know a single form of 21 forms. You need a lot of sutras. Therefore subantas is easier to know. You can know akaranta, akaranta, akaranta pullinga, halanta pullinga, akaranta strilinga, and then neuters, some kinds of some declensions, and most of these will fall, most of the words will fall into one of these. So you know 5 or 10 various types of declensions over a period of time, you will get a lot, you will get almost the entire language of nouns. So subanta is easier. Now krit pratyaya, when you add to dhatu, that dhatu can be used as a noun. Now as in instead of declining it as a Tinganta Pada, you can decline. And what a Tinganta Pada can do, Kridanta can do a lot more than that. For example, what we have seen, to recall, not an example, the what does the Tinganta Pada denote? It denotes either a Karta in Kartari Prayoga, Karma in Karmani Prayoga, or itself, as in the Kriya of the Dhatu in Bhave Vipatti, in Bhave Prayoga. There, other than these, there are a lot of Karakas, Kartrakaraka, Karma Karaka, and Bhave Vipatti we can do with Tinganta. But what about the other Karakas? The Karakas such as Karana Karaka is remaining. In the third case, what we show in the third case, Karana Karaka, Sampradana Karaka, all these other Karakas up to Adhikarana, for all of these, you cannot denote those by a Tinganta Pada. Therefore, these Karakas can be denoted in Krit Pratyas, and therefore, Krit Pratyas, when you add to a Dhatu, these Kridantas give you a vast usage. They all, the Kridanta can denote all the Karakas, denote as in it can be in the sense of any Karaka, need not be only Karta or a Karma or a Bhava. It can have any kind of Vyutpatti, it can have a Adhikarana Vyutpatti, it can have a Sampradana. So all of these, it can have any kind of Vyutpatti. So all Karakas are possible with Kridanta. Therefore, Kridanta makes the language open up completely and with an easier usage. So you see lot of Kridanta usage in modern Sambhashana. You don't see lot of Tinganta because moreover, this Kridanta also can give some Lakara Artha also. It can be in the past tense, it can be in load sense. So all these Lakara senses also can be denoted by Kridanta. The only issue is now Kridanta word can be in multiple senses. So once you see a Kridanta, you have to identify which sense it has been used in the language. So analyzing becomes difficult, although usage is easier. But it also gives a lot of flavor. There are more possibilities in a particular word itself, single word itself. So Kridanta, how do you get it? So let's say Kartari Vispatti. In the Kartari Kartari sense, the Trich Pratyaya is used to derive the Karta of the Kriya in the Dhatu. So if you add it to Jnya Dhatu, a Trich Pratyaya, then you will get a Pratipadika which has a sense of the agent of the action of that Dhatu Jnya. So agent to know means knower. Agent of the action to know, knower. So Jnya plus Trich will give you a knower. Sorry. Chakara is at the end and it is dropped off. So the content is through. Pratipadika will be Jnya through. So Jnyatru means a knower, and it will be declared as Jnyata, Jnyataru, Jnyataraha. That is how the declension is. Jnyataram, Jnyataru, Jnyatrun. So this is how, like Dhatru Shabda, Rukaranta, Pullinga Shabda, that's how it will decline. Now this Jnyatru also, if it has to be used as a Strilinga, then some other changes have to be made. So a Pratipadika, which is in masculine, to use it as a feminine, there is a feminine pratyaya which is added further, and nyatru becomes nyatri. You get nyatri in feminine. Similarly, another pratyaya is kta. These are the most frequently used pratyas. Trich pratyaya, which will give a karta. Kta pratyaya, where kakara is an it letter. It letter meaning that which will be elided. It is like a packaging letter or a header or a footer in a for programmers, those who know, header or a footer which carries some data which is like a which is a metadata. It indicates something which is not useful for a layman. It is used for a grammarian. In this case, there it is used for an engineer. Similarly, here this the kakara as an it letter, it has a sense of some kind of a. It indicates something. It indicates some kriya in derivation. So when kakara goes, the content will be ta, takara and akara ta. When you add it to jnya, you will get jnyata, and ta is added in the sense of past tense. It will something which is already achieved, already done, the kriya which is already done. So the object of the action, object of the kriya indicated by the dhatu is the sense of the taanta pada. So jnata will means that which is known, object of to know means object that is known, already known, achieved. So jnata is that which is known. Yeah, I didn't take the laukika vigraha. For jna plus trich, it will be janati. So one who knows janati, janati iti jnata. This is the laukika vigraha. The alaukika vigraha is jna plus trich. So this is a pratipadika. This is a jnata is a declined pada in first case, singular. So janati iti jnata is a kartari vitpati. Jnayate is a karmani vitpati. Jnayate iti jnata. So karmani in the bhute sense. In the bhuta kala and karma of bhuta kala is the meaning of ta pratyaya, and karmani, we know karmani takes atmane pratyaya, the kartari takes the parasmai pada pratyaya. So that's why janati but jnayate. Janati, this jnaya becomes ja. When you decline in kartari, you get janati in the prathama purusha ekavachana. Here also prathama purusha ekavachana, but karmani vyutpati, when you do karmani declension, that time you get yak, what we see in yak, ya. Here you have got the gana vikarna pratyaya. This na has come from gana vikarna pratyaya, and I think shna, so it is the ninth gana, nya, shna, so you will get Adibishna, Yashna. So you'll get Janati here. This Na is an additional because it is the Kartari Prayoga, and in Kartari Prayoga you get one of the 10 Gana Vikarna Pratyas based on which Gana the Dhatu belongs to. So you get Janati. Janati iti Jnata, but Jnayate iti Jnataha. Jnayate, that which is known. You will translate this as that which is known in Karmani Prayoga in a passive voice. Jnayate, that which is known, already known, is Jnataha. And nya plus ta is the alaukika vigraha. Nya plus twa, kakara is an it letter, the content is twa. So this is in the sense of having done something, having done the kriya indicated by the dhatu. So nya plus twa will be nyatva. So nyatva, krutva. Krutva means having done. Nyatva means having known. Pitva means having drunk. So this is twa, twa pratyaya. In for kru dhatu, with rich you will get karta. Kartru will be the pratipadika, and the declension will be karta, karta, kartaro, kartarha. This nya dhatu plus twa and kru dhatu plus twa, you will get nyatva, krutva. Having done, having known, having done. Nya plus lyut. Now lyut is in the sense of lot of senses. General senses are bhavya vipatti, which indicates the sense of the, just the kriya of the dhatu. Just the, it's the content of the dhatu, that's all. It's the meaning of the dhatu, that's the lyut pratyaya. Lyut pratyaya, although it is called as lyut, it takes a adesha. It is the adesha is ana, as in the replacement is ana. So lyut will be replaced by ana. So you will see ana will be the content, and you will get jnana. Jnana plus ana will be jnana. There will be dhiriga sandhi, and you will get jnana. And in which senses? Generally, senses seen are bhave, karne, or adhikarne, meaning in the sense of the dhatu itself, the meaning of the dhatu. Third case meaning as an instrumental, as a karaka meaning, or seventh case meaning adhikarna, the locus of the action. So jnana can now mean bhavya vipatti, as in knowledge. It can mean knowledge, in it can also mean karmani vipatti also, possibility. So it can also mean, but karna is more often. So if you see karna, then in karna sense it will be jnana is that through which something is known. So jnana is a means to knowledge. It is not the knowledge, it can be knowledge. Jnana is knowledge also, it is also the means to knowledge, jnana. And in adhikarana, it will be the locus where the action takes place. So where knowledge takes place, so it can also, actually jnana can also indicate where the knowledge is taking place. The adhikarana, it can mean in the sense, it can also mean buddhi. But it can indicate buddhi. This is the general sense of lyut, but lyut is basically akartri cha karake sanyayam. So sanyayam means it has to have that meaning for you to use. So jnana can have the meaning of buddhi by the sutra, but whether jnana can be used in the sense of buddhi, that cannot be decided by a person who does not have understanding of the knowledge. Just because the sutra makes it possible does not mean as in the pratyaya makes it possible, but the sutra restricts it to sanyayam. Sanyayam means laukika usage should be there. Jnana in seventh case with lute is possible, but only if there is such a meaning there. If jnana has been used in the language as the adhikarana, then alone you can call it as buddhi. Otherwise, it cannot be called as buddhi. Jnana will always be either karana or karma. So, general sense is akartari cha karke. Except for karta sense, lute can be used in any karaka. Karaka artha, any of the karas, not non-karaka, any of the karaka artha, except for karta, kartra karaka. So, bhava is also possible, karma is possible, karana is possible, sampradana is possible, apadana is possible, and adhikarana is possible. All possibilities exist except for sambandha, which is not a karaka. Sixth case is not possible, and karta is not possible. There is another pratyaya which you use a similar form, but that is not lyup, that is lyu. And lyu will also get this ana adesha. Anyway, that is just a FYI. So, which are the other pratyayas? We have seen trich, ta, lyut, twa. These are most common. So, others are also there, but we will not touch those because we will see when we reach there. If at all there are other uses. Lyu is one we saw. There is also null. Null is also in the sense of karta, I just mentioned this. And null becomes aka. Just like lyut becomes ana, the null will become akar, but it will also be a in the sense of null trucho. So null trucho karta, in the sense of karta you will get. So karaka, one who does. So that kru plus akar will become karaka. So karaka is that which does. That's also possible. There are other meanings also. Akar will come in some other sense also, but I'm just mentioning other krut pratyas are possible, and there are a lot of krut pratyas. Taddita vritti is when you derive a sambandha of more than one pratipadika, two pratipadikas, basically two nouns. When there is a sambandha between two, and that sambandha is denoted by a pratyaya, which is added to a pratipadika. What we saw is dasharati, dasharatasya putraha, dasharatasya tasya putraha. Dasharatasya tasya is a noun, is a pronoun which can be anything which will be added to this pratipadika. It will actually be a noun in sixth case. Which has a sambandha with another word. So putra, that is, what is the sambandha? That is putra, tasya putra. In that sense, you will get dasharathi, dasharatasya putraha dasharathi. The pratyaya content is e. So basically, you say sambandha. Which sambandha is complicated, as in even people who have studied for many years, Taddita is very vast. It is a complicated section. There are multiple things that you have to take care of to see the meaning. Multiple pratyas are possible in the same meaning, and same pratyaya is possible in the sense of multiple sambandhas. Therefore, taddita becomes very difficult to know what is the sambandha. So, basic understanding should be that pratipadika, if you can see dasharata there, and you see adi vriddhi, the earlier letter takes a vriddhi. So, dasharata, the akara, dakara, akara, dasharata, in dasharata, that will take vriddhi, and vriddhi for akara is akara. So, you get da, da will become da. And dasharatha will become dasharatha, and then ikara is the content of the pratyaya, which will replace the last akara. Instead of dasharatha, it will become dasharathi. So you can say dasharatha sambandhi dasharathi. That's all we need to know right now. What is the exact sambandha will be told by some commentator. Although we can find out with lot of effort, commentators help us as what are the possible sambandhas, and this is how we understand the taddita vritti. Now look at the pratipadika eka. Now tva is, we look at some taddita pratyas because these are common. Tva shenj. Tva and shenj, the content of shenj is ya. Yakara is the, ya, yakara and akara, ya is the content. So tva, ya, ta, these three, ta in strilinga, tva and ya in napunsakalinga. In these are in the same sense. What is that? Tasya bhava. Tasya bhava means the quality of that. The quality of that in that sense, in the sense of quality of that is the sambandha. The quality is connected to a particular thing, and that thing is denoted by a pratipadika, is denoted by using a name, that is a pratipadika. And eka, so eka is the, is that has to be talked about, the one entity, one. So when you are talking about one, tasya bhavaha, ekasya bhavaha, एकस्य भावः इन दैट सेंस यू कैन यूज थ्री प्रत्ययस फॉर स्त्रीलिंग यू कैन यूज ता यू विल गेट एकता सो एकता मीन्स द क्वालिटी ऑफ बीइंग वन वननेस सो व्हिच वी ऐड बाय इन इंग्लिश यू यूज नेस सो वननेस एकता एकत्व एकत्वम इट विल बी डिक्लेयर्ड इन न्यूटर एकत्वम इन स्त्रीलिंग एकता एकता एकत्वम और ऐक्यम ऐक्यम दिस हियर this nyakara in the end of the pratyaya, this nyakara as I said tick letter, this can bring adi vruddhi, it can bring some kind of vruddhi, not adi vruddhi, but here in tadita it will be adi vruddhi, you will get aikya, a, ekaha, a, there will be vruddhi of the letter a, and a, the vruddhi for a is ai, so you get aik, aik, and a will be replaced by this ya, when a is replaced by ya, you will get ekya, but आदि वृद्धि आफ्टर आदि वृद्धि विल गेट ऐक्य सो ऐक्यम एंड इन न्यूट्रल विल बी ऐक्यम सो एकस्य भावः कैन बी एकता एकत्वम और ऐक्यम दैट इज द वननेस दिस इज द मोस्ट कॉमन प्रत्यय देन देयर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड एज मतुप मतुप विच इज मत एंड मतुप इज इन द सेंस ऑफ इट हैज इट समथिंग दैट सो अस्य अस्ति अस्मिन् वा सो अस्य अस्ति इट वन हैज समथिंग a quality or something one possesses something if someone has dhana then he will be called as dhana plus mat will actually sometimes ma will become va and you can get dhana dhana mat will become dhanavat so it will be declared as dhanavan or lakshmivan lakshmiman so bhagavan bhagavat bhagavan so mat can become vat it means one who has bhaga one who has dhana one who has lakshmi that will be indicated by the matu pratyaya mat pratyaya to the pratipadika and this is one who so if you say matruman pitruman one who has mata or one who has pita and when it is declined matru mat will be declared matruman bhagavat will be declared bhagavan bhagavan bhagavanto bhagavantah matruman matru matrumanto matrumantah so when it declined this word this is how it is declined but everyone has a mother or a father everyone has dhana so everyone should be called as dhanavan everyone has some dhana if nothing one has 1 rupee in his pocket he should be called as dhanavan as per the vipatti but that's not the meaning here matu the meaning is one who has it but has plenty prashasyatara so one who has lot of it that is the meaning of the matu artha one has it or one has it within him within itself so that will also tasyasti asyasti asmin va it is in this or it has or it is in this in that sense matup is used in absolute measure so virtue in absolute measure quality in absolute measure in a lot of in plenty in abundance that is the meaning of matup then there is ini is also in the same sense as matup matup arthe so there is a lot of pratyayas which are matup arthe so we will say matup arthe ini in the sense of matup meaning one who has jnani so jnani jna plus ini will become jnani so pratipriya is jnanin jnanin inanta that is inanta and inanta there are different declinations the book will mention inantas are declined this way jnani so jnanin the nakara will be dropped off by one sandhi rule that we saw the nakara at the end of the pratipadika which is also at the end of a pada is undergoes lopa it is dropped off so jnani and then there is a dirgha of this jnani jnani it will be jnani jnanino jnaninah that is how the declination will be so jnanam asya asti iti jnani earlier it will be bhagah asya asti iti bhagavan one who has bhaga is called bhagavan one who has jnana is called jnani so that is the laukika vigraha then and is tasya apatyam in that sense apatyam puman or stri so apatyam means a descendant so descendant of someone descendant of something that is called as that is the vritti that is the sambandha descendant so bharata sambandhi is the first understanding of the word which has a tadita pratyaya in the end which word bharata so bharata is this and this nakara will called adi cause adi vruddhi and you will get bha bhakara will become bha bha, bha plus akara that akara following bha, bhakara will become a and you will get Bharata. What is Bharata? Bharata Sambandhi is the first understanding. If you understand this much, that is sufficient. Bharata Sambandhi. What is the Sambandha? Tasya Apatyam Puman. Puman is a son or a, actually male. So, a descendant, male descendant. Male descendant will be called as Tasya Apatyam Puman. And if you add it to Bharata, you will say Bharatasya Apatyam Puman equal to Bharataha. Similarly, Bharatasya Apatyam, but Stri, if you say Stri, a daughter, it will be Bharati. Bharataha Bharati. So that's the anpratya, which is in the sense of Tasya Apatyam. And then Tasil. Tasil is also common. Tasil is in the fifth case. Fifth case meaning. So this is very common. Tad plus Tasil. Tas is the content and Sakara becomes Visarga. So you will get Taha. Taha will be added to Tad. This Tad, when you add Taha, this Dakara drops off and you get Tataha. So Tataha, Ataha, we mean Tasmat, Asmat. So meaning is Tasmat. Tasmat can be replaced by a Tasil instead of a Subanta. This Tasmat is a Subanta declension. Tataha will be a Tasil Anta Subanta. So it will be, it's an avyaya, it's an indeclinable. You get Tataha to mean Tataha, Ataha will be Tasmat or Asmat. We'll not look into the Alaukika Vigraha here. Tad plus Thal. Now this is, Thal is Prakaravachi in particular manner. So Thal, the content is Tha. So Tatha. So Tatha, this Dakara will go, you will get Tatha. Tha is the content of the Pratyaya. So Tatha. Tatha in that manner. That is Tatha. Tena Prakarana. Meaning is Prakaravachi. So Tena Prakarana. In that manner. In which manner? In whichever manner will be described. So in that manner will be said as Tena Prakarana you can say, or you can say Tatha. Yatha Tatha. So Yad, if you add it to Yad, you will get Yatha. In which manner? In that manner. Yatha Tatha. Yatha Bhavati Tatha. So just as it is, in which manner it is, in that manner itself. So you say Yatha Bhavati Tatha, that is the vyutpatti, that is the usage, the usage for adverb. How is the adverb, adverbial sense? So one runs speedily. So Vegena Dhavati. Dhavati means one runs. And how does he run? Speedily. So speedily is adverbial usage, which is said as Vegena or Vegam. Vegam or Vegena, both second case singular and third case any number is used, any vachana is used for adverbial sense. So Vegena or Vegam, Vegena, Vegam va dhavati. So Vegena or Vegam, when you say adverbial, how do you say that? Yatha bhavati tata. Vegam yatha bhavati tata dhavati. How that speed is possible, in that manner he runs. That is the adverbial sense. Yatha bhavati tata. And that is the manner is prakaravachi. So tena prakarana dhavati. Vegam yatha bhavati tata dhavati. So those are the pratyas for taddita. Samasa vritti. Samasa will take a little more time. So what else is there? Ekashesha. Ekashesha will not look at it. Ekashesha I have already covered. So we'll look at samasa. I'll just mention which are the different types of samasas. We'll look at a couple of examples and move on to Tattva Bodha. Samasa vritti. Samasa vritti is a compound. The basic compound, the most, which are the various types of compounds? Okay, let's look at four types of samasas. One is an avyayi bhavaha, avyayi bhava, tatpurusha samasa, brahuvrihi samasa, and the last is dvandva samasa. We look at dvandva first, which is the most simplest of the samasas. There is a purva pada and uttara pada. This is how we will say samasas are formed. Two padas. Purva pada earlier, uttara pada later pada. And there are rules as to which can go earlier, which can go later in any type of samasa. In all types of samasa, these are the four basic types. There are other varieties are there. But these are the four types of samasas. When you add them, the earlier pada, which should be the earlier pada, that is the grammar describes it as to which can go in a compound, which can become the earlier, which can become the later. Thereby, the basic samasa is dvandva samasa. Dvandva samasa is two or more. Generally, in samasa, two words are added together. But dvandva allows in one vritti itself, one vigraha vakya, in one statement itself, you can make add multiple, more than two. So more than two. So Ramaha, and it is Chakarte Chakarartha. In the Chakarartha, Dvandva compound is Chakara meaning and. So if you want to talk about multiple entities, and generally they have to be related. So if you are saying Ramaha cha Lakshmanaha cha Bharataha cha Sita cha, so all this if you want to add, so let's say Ramaha, Lakshmana and Bharata, Rama and Lakshmana and Bharata, if you want to talk about in a compound, it will be Rama, Lakshmana, Bharata. So the compound will be Rama, Lakshmana, Bharataha. The plural is maintained plural because there are three or more will take a plural ending. So Ramaha, Lakshmana, Ramascha, Lakshmanascha, Bharatascha will become Rama, Lakshmana, Bharataha. But if you are two, Rama and Lakshmana, it will be in dual. Declension will be in dual. Ramascha, Lakshmanascha will become Rama, Lakshmanau. Rama, Lakshmanau. This is one type of Dvandva Samasa, which is called as Itaretara Dvandva. Itaretara Dvandva is when the gender and the ending declension of the word, the compounded word, the ending gender, the word which is at the end, the last pada, uttara pada, we will call it uttara pada, the last pada, the gender and the number is maintained and that pratyaya is added. So if there are three entities or four entities, more than three entities in the compound, then the plural pratyaya is used. If there are only two, then the dual pratyaya is used. So that is one giveaway of Itaretara Dvandva. The other is that the gender is maintained. So if it is Sita in the end, then it will be declined like a Srilinga. Although Rama is also there. Ramaha and Sita. Rama Sita will become Rama Sita. Rama, actually, it will not be Rama Sita. It will be Sita Rama. Generally, it is what goes first will be defined by the sutra. So I may not be accurate. Since we are going in without sutras as basis, I may not be accurate, so don't consider as Rama Sita as a possibility. It may be, because I have to go through the rules, I don't remember all the rules offhand. But let's assume that Rama Sita is, Rama and Sita can be put together as Rama in the beginning and Sita in later. Then with that assumption, if I have to say Rama and Sita, then the Sita ending, Sita will be declined different to Rama. Rama will be Ramaha Ramo. Sita will be Sita Sita. So that Sita declension will be possible. Generally it is not written as Rama Sita, it will be written as Sita Rama only. But I am saying as a possibility, if multiple are written, then but Rama Sita may also, in Dvandva it may be possible. So I am giving a possibility, Rama Sita it will look like. Gender is retained and the number is retained. That is Itaretara Dvandva. When you are talking about a group, instead of individual entities which are say Ramaha, Lakshmana and Sita, so or Rama, Lakshmana and Bharata, let's say Rama, Lakshmana, Bharata will be Rama, Lakshmana, Bharataha, Gacchanti, you will say, because it is in plural, you will use the plural verb also in Kartari Prayoga, Rama, Lakshmana, Bharataha, Gacchanti, Rama, Lakshmana, Gacchataha, both are going. So this is how you use the sentence. But if you want to talk about them as a group, some related entities as a group, and there also what can be grouped together is defined. In that case, you will get another type of Dvandva Samasa, which is Samahara Dvandva. Samahara is a grouping, and Samahara Dvandva will be declined in neuter singular. It is a group, so any group is an in Ekavachana. So Samahara Dvandva will be in neuter. And it will always be in neuter and it will always be in singular. So, one example is given as the Praniyanga. Praniyanga is the limbs of a sentient being are put together. So, you see Pani and Pada. Paniya means hands. Hari Hari. So, Pani, two hands and two feet put together. So, you say Padaha Padau. So two pani and padau, when they put together two hands and two feet, then as a group it will be declined in samahara dvandva and it will be neuter and singular. So you will get pani padam. You have heard this word pani padam. So feet and hands and feet, that's what it means when grouped, pani padam. We'll look at the other types of samasa in the next class. We'll look at little summary. And then I think today is Wednesday, so Friday samasa will take a little time. I'll finish the samasa on Friday, and we'll look at a little bit of summary of what we have done so far. Just go through that, and from Monday onwards we'll start the Tubodha. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.